Good morning, class one. Hope you all are fine, class one. Okay, class one, in the last class, I have taught you about the parts of a computer. Okay, so we have learned about CPU and keyboard. Okay, so this week, we are going to learn about a mouse. So you see, mouse, computer mouse is also a part of a, is also a part of a computer. Now children, don't think mouse which is in your home, rat, okay, not that, this is your computer mouse. So computer mouse help us, okay, to do so many work. So without mouse, we cannot do many tasks in computer, that means we cannot perform different types of work in a computer. So today we are going to learn about what? Today we are going to learn about the mouse. Now mouse I will draw and I will show you, okay, what is a computer mouse. So look at the blackboard. You see a simple mouse I'm drawing here. Okay, this is your simple mouse. This is your computer mouse. Okay, this is what? This is your mouse. M-O-U-S-E. So mouse is also a part of your computer. Okay, this is also part of your computer. So you see, today we are going to talk about the mouse. So you see, this mouse, it also helps to give a command to the computer. So without mouse, we cannot give command. Today, you want to open paint for making a drawing. So you see, we required a mouse to give a command. Today, you want to write something. So you want to open MS Words. Okay, so to open MS Words also, we required a mouse so that we will click. Okay, there is a two button will be there, left click and right click. In the middle, there will be scroll bar. So you see, when school will open, I will take you to the lab and then you all will see how the mouse work. Okay, so at that time, it will be very much clear to you all. Now see, so it has a two button or three button in some of the mouse. Nowadays, the mouse, it has a two button. Okay, and in the old time, most of the mouse, they used to have a three button. So you see, this is one button. This is one button, two button. So one, two. So mouse has got two button. In some of the mouse, it has how many button? Three button it can be. Okay. But in most of the mouse, there is a two buttons. Now, you see, so we are able to draw. See, in your monitor, you are able to draw with the help of a mouse. You see, suppose this is your monitor screen. Okay, children. Suppose this is your monitor. Suppose this is your monitor. Now, if you want to draw, suppose you want to draw a tree. So, in that case, we have to click without giving a command. You see, only this mouse will help to give a command. Okay, then only we can draw. Without mouse, you cannot draw anything. Suppose you want to draw a tree. You want to draw a tree. Okay, so you see, you have to give a command with the help of a, with the help of a mouse. See, you want to put a color. Okay, suppose see, I'm putting a color. Okay, I'm putting a color like in this tree. So you see, you can put color with the help of a mouse also, with the help of a mouse. So the mouse will help you to, okay, put color in computer. So you see, in computer, in MS Paint, there'll be so many colors. So you can select the color with the help of a mouse and you can put it on the tree. Okay, so you see, so everything we can do in a computer with the help of a mouse. So mouse will give command to a computer. So if mouse is not there, so we cannot give a command to the computer. We cannot say, okay, I will draw with a chalk, or I will take a pencil and I will draw on the monitor. It is not possible. You know, children, when you all are making a drawing, you are taking pencil, you take your drawing book, you can draw it. If wrong, you can erase it. But can you take pencil and draw on the monitor screen? No, it is not possible. So you can draw in MS Paint with the help of a mouse only. So if there is no mouse, we will not be able to draw beautiful diagrams. Okay, children, so to draw a diagram also, we require the very important part of a computer, that is your mouse. Okay, and one more very interesting thing, many children, they play game. Okay, they they play game in a computer. So when they are playing game in a computer, so they may use a mouse to play the game also. Okay, so in many games are there where your mouse plays very important role. So without mouse, you will not be able to play the game. Okay, so mouse helps you to play the game also. So you are able to draw pictures. Okay, so this is the importance of your mouse. So what does the mouse do? The mouse gives command to the computer. So whatever we do, command means what? So without command, the computer will not be doing any works. Today, suppose you don't have a mouse, you have monitor, you have CPU, you have a keyboard, and you don't have a mouse. Okay, so it becomes very difficult, okay, for anyone to draw. So you see, without mouse, we cannot give command. I cannot say the computer, computer, draw a tree. So computer will not draw a tree. Okay, so we have to give a command. So command we are giving to the computer with the help of a mouse. Okay, so with the help of a mouse only we are able to give a command. So if there is no mouse, we will not be able to draw on a computer. So you see children, you can draw very beautiful, beautiful pictures on a computer. And this all thing is possible only with the help of your mouse. So when school will open, I will take you to the computer lab, and in a practical class, we will draw and we will do so many activities in your computers. So you can draw, you can put color. So it is going to be very interesting. Okay. Now you see the other part, the part connected to a computer. So you see, we have learned CPU, monitor, keyboard, mouse. These all are connected with your computer. Okay. We have learned from in this chapter 3, the parts of a computer. So many parts, that is your CPU, monitor, keyboard, mouse. So you see, CPU, keyboard, monitor, keyboard, mouse, these all are part of your computer we have learned. So you see, CPU, very important part of a computer. It is also called brain of a computer. Monitor, keyboard, and mouse. So these are your part of a computer. So today, few other parts we are going to see. Okay, so about few parts we are going to learn now. See, we are going to learn about printer. Okay, we are going to learn about printer. P-R-I-N-T-E-R, printer. See children, printer. Okay, the printer help you to work. Take your work on a paper. See, now if you make a drawing, suppose you made a drawing. Now you see I'm making a small drawing here. Monitor this is. Suppose you made a tree. Okay, now you see. And suppose this is your printer. I'm making a printer. Okay, this is your printer. Now, suppose this is your printer. And you want to print this. Okay, you want to print this tree. So you see, this printer will help you to print it. So you see, papers are here. Okay, when we will give command print, when we will click on the print, so what will happen? On the paper, this tree, okay, it will come out. So whatever we are making on the paper, with the help of printer, we can print it out. Today, suppose you made a cat. Okay, so when you will try to print it, so from the printer the same cat will come out. So printer help you to, okay, get the same image or the pictures that you draw on the monitor screen. So whatever, okay, whatever you write on the monitor screen, the same will come out from your printer. Okay, next is speaker and headphones. Children, you know headphones. Nowadays many of you are very clever because you have seen headphone. So many people, while listening music through the Bluetooth, they put a headphone. Okay, so you see in computer also headphones are there through which you can listen song, other will not get disturbed. Okay, and speaker, you see there are some speakers are also there. Okay, speaker, you know, it will be near the, okay, it will be beside the computer, two speaker, S-P-E-A-K-E-R-S, speakers. Now you see, this is the speaker. Today, suppose you are playing a music on a computer. So when you play a music, sound should come. So this sound will come from this speaker. So you see, speaker is there in your home also. Okay, suppose you have a music system. So when you play a music, from where the sound is coming, you see you have a small, big, okay, so many speaker are there. From the speaker, the sound comes. And you enjoy the song, you dance with the song. Okay, now you see computer also have a speaker. Okay, small speaker will be there beside the computer. So you see, suppose you're playing music or you're playing some video. So what will happen? From the speaker, the sound will come. So you see, printer and speaker, they are also part of your computer. And even your headphones also. Okay, so headphones are, it helps to listen to the music. Okay, next is scanner. Okay, now we are going to talk about the scanner. You see, S-C-A-N-N-E-R. Okay, this is also one of the part of a computer. Okay, so scanner is used to put your picture into the computer. So scanner is a machine. It is a machine. Okay, suppose this is your computer. Okay, it is connected with your, this is your monitor screen, this is your scanner. Now you see, suppose you want to bring the pictures onto the computer. Now, suppose you took one small paper and on the paper there is a picture there. Suppose there is a picture of a cat. Okay, there is a picture of a cat is there. So we have to put this picture here on the scanner and close the scanner, press the button. So what will happen? This cat picture will come on the monitor screen. Okay, so scanner help to copy the image or the pictures from the scanner to the monitor screen. So it help, it is like a Xerox. Okay, it's not exactly a Xerox. So it is helps to copy the same thing. So whatever picture you will put on the scanner, the same picture will come on the monitor screen. Okay, so this type of machine is called scanner. Okay, next is, we are going to talk about UPS. Okay, now you see, we are going to talk about UPS. Okay, now you see, we are going to talk about UPS. See children, in your home also, there is an inverter is there. Okay, when electricity goes, quickly the inverter starts. Okay, so you see in computer also, there is a UPS. So UPS is also a small machine. Okay, it is also small in size. It has a button. Now you see, this UPS, it also work like your inverter. So when electricity will go, okay, suppose there is no electricity. So at that time, you can run your computer with the help of UPS. Okay, so this UPS will help you, this UPS will help us to run the computer when there is no electricity. Okay, you see it full form. Okay, now you see. Uninterrupted power supply. Okay. Now see children, okay, full form of UPS, U means uninterrupted, okay, uninterrupted, uninterrupted power supply, okay, its full form is uninterrupted power supply. That means when there is no power supply means when there is no electricity, if electricity will go, okay, so for a few minutes, you can, with the help of UPS, you can run your computer, okay, so this UPS is working like your inverter, okay, so when there is no electricity, so this UPS will help, okay, to run the computer for a certain interval of time, that is for a short period of time, and its full form is U stand for uninterrupted, P stand for power, S stand for supply. So uninterrupted power supply. Okay, so you see, today how many we have learned? So many parts of a computer we have learned. So you see, in the last class we have learned about what? We have learned about CPU, monitor, keyboard, mouse. Okay, so today we have learned about mouse. Then we have learned about printer. Yes, we have learned about the printer. Then we have learned about the speakers. Okay, then we have learned about the scanner. And we have learned about the UPS. So see children, so we have learned about the CPU. See the last conclusion of the chapter. So we have learned about the CPU, monitor, keyboard, mouse. They are the four important part of a computer. And other parts are your printer, P-R-I-N-T-A, printer, speaker, S-P-E-A-K-E-R-S, speaker, scanner, S-C-A-N-N-E-R, scanner. Okay, and UPS. Okay, so these all are parts of your computer. So in this way our chapter gets over. Okay children, so whatever I have taught you, listen. Okay, whatever homework I will give you, will write it down. Okay, so do it very properly and study very properly, and everyone must do it. Okay, class one, most of you are, many of you, like last time I have conducted test. Okay, very less children have submitted. Only 21 of you have, only very less, I think 12 only have submitted. So more and more students should submit the papers. Okay, so more children should give the papers and do it very nicely. Learn and write in your copy also, whatever homework I will give you for today. Thank you.